Geralt and Yennefer were reunited, but something even more important happened in Vizima. Geralt learned that Cirilla, his one-time ward, had returned from afar, and she was in danger. He was to find her at the Emperor's command and Yennefer's behest.
Ugly bastard. That's silver.
Where'd you come from?
You know, Witcher, folk can say what they will. Me, I'll never forget what you did for us.
Greetings.
Greetings.
If I ever have a son, I'll name him Geralt.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
bad today.
Come on.
It always sat there empty, this hut. That is, till the night afore the battle. A man arrived, walked right in like 'twere his own. Standing at the window, peering at the goings-on. Must have been, 'cause next I knew, there he was, coming my way. So, I grabbed me pan, for protection, see? But he just asks all polite, Gran. Got any birch bark, by chance? Lilac berries, or even a few coals? Nay, says I. And you must be right daft to pester folk at night with such foolery. But I sees you listening, just staring at me pan like a magpie at a copper. Lend it to me, Gran. I'll give it back come morn. He's right baffled for what's he doing, frying in the dark. But I've got a soft heart, so I gave it to him.
Interesting. What happened then?
Afore dawn, another rode up to the hut. But come morn, only the first fella left. Locked the door, hopped on his horse, and that were all I saw of him, and me pan. 'Twere old, black with soot, not worth much, I suppose. But I've no other. Will you help me, dearie? Bring an old widower pan. I could never break down that door myself. And in truth, I'm afeard to go in any road. Such a stench wafting out. Methinks the other fellow. Well, that he's lying there.
Never taken on a pan contract. Fine, I'll go in, look around.
You should wait here, just in case.
Thank you.
A corpse. Explains the stench. Cracked monocle. Interesting.
What's that, dearie?
Nothing, nothing.
His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind a soldier might have.
But when I gab to myself, they say I'm going barmy.
Documents. Almost entirely burnt. A few pieces still legible. Priceless frying pan. Scrubbed clean. Looks like the mystery man didn't need the pan so much as the soot off it to make ink, write letters.
Found the pan, have ye?
Here, your frying pan.
Mine? But mine were black with soot, and I could see myself in this one if I wanted. But them years are past.
It was the soot the man needed. He scraped it off to make ink. Must have had an urgent letter to write. Urgently burned some other documents, too.
And the other fellow?
Dead. Round up a few boys and bury him outside the village. Deep, so the necrophages don't dig him up. And take my advice. Don't mention this to the Nilfgaardians.
Hang about! You've earned a token of thanks. Here, son, for the road. Fry up a nice white fish for some... or a pie.
You'll not get food, not from me. What do you want, wanderer?
deer stick the bark off the trees again. What now? Any tidings from Vizima?
Hey-ya! Not so fast, Roach. Hey-ya! Let's go! Run, Roach.
Yeah.
A return customer. Welcome.
New forge any good?
Splendid. Nilfgaardians brought a two-chamber bellows from Mahakam, then sent to Vizima for a crack builder. Fellow built a brick hearth and a chimney in no time. Only thing is, the local folk don't buy from me no more. They ride to Goslet, half a day's road, even though the duffer there's never forged a decent hoe in his life.
But he's a human, that it? Be careful, Willis. And if the tide turns and Nilfgaard abandons White Orchard, you leave with them. Humans won't forgive you for that boy's death. Show me what you got.
I'd like you to forge something for me. So long.
Hello, there's the griffin. What do you say we go fishing?
Oh.
We'll talk about this later.
The girl told me about the squid.
What happened to your
mom? I've been missing one day, so I hope that the witch was hunting nearby and started poking the mask.
Thank you.
magic. A place of power. Of power.
Come on.
base of power. Should draw from it. Just destroy it.
Move it!
Magic. A place of power.
Come on, Roach. Let's go!
Magic. A place of power.
Giddy up.
Faster. magic. A place of power.
Go, go.
Yes?
Where's Lena? Something happened?
She passed away, soon after you'd left.
You resent my choice, I understand. But believe me, my potions wouldn't have helped.
Alas, I must take your word for it.
Tell me something about yourself. What's your story?
A sad one. Do you know the Temple of Melitele in Alanda?
Do I know it? Can't remember how many times I've been there, how many times Mother Nenica stitched me up.
We must have missed each other. I started to become a healer under Mother Nenica. I was but 18 when they took me in. An age at which teachings interest one far less than love. There was a boy, Goslath. He'd bare his chest to work. The novices couldn't keep their eyes off him, tripped over their own feet, dropped things. I left the temple for him. We passed a lovely summer together, and then he left. Nenike refused to take me back. My parents uttered not a word, gave me a travel cloak and a small coin pouch. I struggled long to find a place where I'd feel safe, needed, until I finally arrived here. End of story.
Listen, ever heard of a woman named Claire? Lived around here?
Heard of her? A mild way to put it. Claire was a friend. The only person dear to me in all of White Orchard. Until her husband, Volker, quarreled with the Lord of the Manor. He then gathered the family, moved out into the woods to start a new settlement. The Lord and his retinue rode there to convince them to return. They were to be civil. No forcing, no bloodshed. But you saw. Word is Claire said something about the Lord's son, Florian. Something that made the Lord furious. But who knows the truth?
Lots of misfortune for such a small village.
'Tis so in every village. Even the smallest. You need only ask. But let's not end on a teary note. Here, a bit of solace. Yes?
Got any herbs you're willing to sell?
I'm sure I can find something.
Farewell.
The Emperor shall guide us straight to Novigrad.
Hoi! Find cover!
This is too much! Nordling?
Back or go for it. Too far afield, this.